Hello, Alex here, Roaster Alex, and today I got a package in that everyone has been waiting for. So I'm going to unbox my new parking sensors. They are the upgraded version of the ones I had on my previous Vauxhall Twintop, which you can see over here. They should be the same, just color display and everything, fancy bancy. So keep watching if you want to know how they are. So the parking sensors are coming in a fixed box, and quite heavy. Had to pay custom fees over it because they actually put the correct price on it, which normally they don't do. So just show you in the video, you know, what I had to pay for this. They were $43, so about £35. I will show you and the customs fee on top of it. So just let's start it, get started, and let's unbox this parking sensor over here. So here's the box. Well, it says dual core, so it should be quicker, better, you know, those things. So let's open it up and see what's in it. So when you open up the box, so in the box we have manual, in English actually, so that's a good thing. We have the hole saw, which is 22mm, I think I have a few of them. We have display, which is here, 2.5-inch display, which you can relocate and locate and do whatever you want. Then there is the power cable. Then we have, well, just put them here, 8 sensors with all labeled where they should go. Oh, that's for that 4, I think. And then we have another 4 sensors here. And then we have the control box with, in the back, if you can see it, which one should go there and where. And then there is this one. So that's basically what's in the box. As far as I could see, it feels quite solid. But I have some stuff there that I can power up the display and see if it does anything. So I might include it in this video, not sure. But this is what's in the box for now. Before I get into the part of showing you, you know, how the display looks and, you know, how bright it is, etc. I want to make sure that I include the part that cables that I mentioned earlier, 4 of them, those are actually extension cables, which are labeled as well. If you can see there as E, for example. So those are for wherever is the longest one. So for the front box or the rear, depending on where your box is located. They say the box should be in the rear. However, you know, everyone has their own way of putting cables. The other thing I want to say is that the plug, which is basically these, just be careful because they do seem to fall out a bit. Not sure why, maybe it's the quality, but make sure that you connect the box somewhere securely so the cables, you know, don't fall out. But other than that, it doesn't look too bad. It has some sounds, we'll show you that as well. So in the next part, you will see the display and how it looks. This is how this sounds. You can see, I basically move my hands. So that's the end of the video. A bunch of wires here, books, saws, you know, whatever this it should be, and I have a display. So I hope you like how it is. I know they make also, you see in the video it only beeps, but it does make a stop sound, like stop, 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 something like it. just have to check how it is. I didn't like it. I had it in my previous car. Turned it off. And actually turned off the beep as well. Because it's gonna just very, very annoying. However, you know, it has that option. I will, you know, in the installation video, I will show how it is. No matter what, no, this is the end of the video. And if you feel like buying parking sensors, you know, you can consider those. I just like to have a display. Other people don't like to have a display. So you make up your mind. See you next time.